My name's Tom, and I'm a fourth year medical student at the University of Queensland. And welcome to the Great Court. The Great Court is the spiritual and traditional heart of the University of Queensland. And as you can see, it is a really great place to be. Surrounded by the beautiful sandstone, cloisters and facade of the original foundation buildings of the university, is such a great place to really connect with the university, and so many memories and great times are had in the Great Court here. My journey into medicine started when I was in grade 10 in high school. I had a bit of a mindset shift and knew that I wanted to do something where I was working with people and making a real difference. So with the subjects that I was studying, I decided that medicine was for me. Unfortunately, I was unsuccessful in gaining entry to medical school as a direct applicant from high school. So I enrolled in a Bachelor of Science at the University of Queensland and sat the GAMSAT exam. And I was very fortunate enough to perform quite well on that exam and made my way as a postgraduate student into the Doctor of Medicine at UQ. I'm now in my final year of the program and I've had such an amazing time here. Some of the reasons why I chose the University of Queensland were for its reputation in Australia, but also globally as well. It's one of the universities that has had a medical school for almost its entire inception, and you know, the tradition and the way of doing and way of teaching medicine has it's really strong roots in tradition, but is also on the forefront of innovation, which is a really great mix as a medical student. Public transport in Brisbane's really great as well. The hospitals, as well as all the major universities, are all connected by really, really good busway infrastructure, which means that you can be at the PA hospital seeing patients, and 10 minutes later, a short bus ride, you can be back on the main UQ campus to meet up with friends, grab a movie, or play some sport with your mates as well. Welcome to the Princess Alexandra Hospital. PA Hospital is the second largest hospital in Queensland and the second largest clinical school for the University of Queensland Medical Program. As a final year student here at PA Hospital, I'm here Monday to Friday and I usually start my day at about 7:30 a.m. just in time for morning ward round. The role of a medical student in your final year is all about getting hands-on and practicing your clinical skills. That means talking to patients, seeing patients in your own clinic rooms, and following your senior doctors and learning the skills necessary to be a junior doctor. This is the Translational Research Institute, or the TRI for short, and all years of the medical program are actually taught from this location. Depending on where you're allocated in your first year, you can either be here at the TRI, the Royal Brisbane Clinical School across the river, or at the Mater Clinical School at the Mater Hospital as well. This facility is such an amazing blend of teaching, research, and clinical application as well. It's so close to the hospital, just 50 metres or so away. The medical program at UQ is split into two phases. Phase one, which is the preclinical years, where you're mostly experiencing class types such as lectures, tutorials, and workshops on basic clinical knowledge, clinical skills, and clinical procedures as well. And then there's phase two, which is the clinical years. This is where you're actually spending all of your time in either a hospital or a primary care clinical environment. And you'll be actually with practicing doctors, seeing real patients, and getting to apply the knowledge you've learnt from phase one of the medical program and develop your skills and knowledge in that respect. The other really great thing is that at the TRI building here, we have access to the Integrated Pathology Learning Centre, which allows us to have, first-hand access to real pathological specimens which sounds gross, but it's really cool and it's a great way to access what we're seeing, but at a more microscopic and histological level. So it's kind of cool to be able to correlate the pathology that you see in a glass bottle, maybe a heart that has suffered a heart attack from a real patient some years ago, and actually see that same case or a similar case in the hospital and be able to compare and contrast the disease process, the pathology, and then think about ways that we can prevent those sorts of diseases and those disease processes from happening in patients that we see and that we treat. The Global Change Institute is one of those buildings that's just really cool. It's one of the only buildings on campus that is 100% energy sustainable. That is, it captures and creates all of its own water and energy, and also disposes and treats its own waste as well. It's also a really cool place to hang out, study, and chill with your mates. There's a beautiful, tranquil waterfall in the background and a nice living green wall. And it's a great backdrop to some downtime or just to study. One of the most memorable experiences that I've had in medical school actually happened earlier this year. I was in my intensive care unit rotation at the PA Hospital here in Brisbane, and I was actually called upon for the very first time to perform CPR, cardiopulmonary resuscitation, on an elderly gentleman who was having a cardiac arrest. Of course, this is a skill that we practice in simulation and on mannequins many times as junior medical students, but actually performing that skill and sort of that activity on a real life patient who, condition was in the brink of life and death, was really a touching moment. Unfortunately, this patient succumbed to his illness and we weren't able to revive him, but I was really, taken aback and really, in awe of the work of the medical and nursing and allied health staff who were involved in that that code, as we call it, in the hospital wards. And despite the patient, not making it through the other end, I was really, really happy and really humbled by the intense effort of all those involved to try and revive this gentleman. And it's really sort of humbling to know that despite all of the advances in modern medicine that we have achieved over the last 10, 20, 50, 100, 200 years, that sometimes, life will just take its natural course and there's nothing that we as doctors or as humans can do to prevent that. Thinking and reflecting on situations of life and death is really, really interesting as a final year medical student, and this experience has definitely given me really strong grounding and a really sort of humbling view of life and death. There's more to medical school than just lectures, studying, and tutorials, and being at the hospital the whole time. Fortunately for me, in my 4 years at medical school, I've been involved in the UQ Medical Student Society. And to be honest, this has just made medical school such an amazing and fun experience. The UQMS, as it's more affectionately known as, are responsible for organising academic, social, and sporting events for medical students all across Brisbane. Regardless of which hospital you're at. We have welcome parties, we have social events for each year level and for integrating year levels. We have a huge sports day at the start of every year where we all have a lot of fun down at a local park. We dress up in scrubs and we get up to a little bit of mischief as well. The other great part about the UQMS is the support that they provide for students and the advocacy that they provide to the medical faculty itself, so that you know, our students and our medical program is the best that it can be and is constantly being improved. So if you enjoyed this video and would like to hear more about the top medical schools across Australia, New Zealand and all over the world, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have other questions, please get in touch with us and ask away.